Johann Rupert is a successful business entrepreneur from South Africa who's earned substantial wealth over the course of his career. The South African businessman was placed second in South Africa on Forbes' list of the world's wealthiest individuals for 2020. In order to pursue a business career, the multi-billionaire initially ventured out on his own before returning home to work for his family's tobacco-related company. Rupert proved that he was competent in leading a multi-billion dollar organization after his father's death by restructuring and broadening the business that his father had left behind. So, how did he become rich? What's his story? And what kind of lifestyle does he experience? Let's find out that and much more in today's video. And without further ado, let's get started. He was born in South Africa in the month of June 1950. His father, Anton Rupert, a well-known South African business mogul. At Stellenbosch, he attended Paul Roosh Gymnasium School before continuing his study at the University of Stellenbosch. He didn't complete his economics and company law course at the university since he decided to leave to pursue a business career. Many years after he dropped out, Johann was awarded an honorary doctorate in economics by the same university in 2004. Johann Rupert dropped out of school and relocated to New York City, where he launched his professional career as an entrepreneur. As an apprentice at Chase Manhattan, the budding businessman learned the ropes and worked there for a few years until finding a position at Lazard Frères, where he spent 3 years before returning home. He later on returned to South Africa in 1979, where he co-founded and served as CEO of Rand Merchant Bank, RMB, for some years. RMB Holdings was created in 1984 as a result of a merger between RMB and Rand Consolidated Investments. However, RMB was not Rupert's only venture. He also founded a number of other businesses. After leaving RMB, Johann Rupert went to work for his father's company, the Rembrandt Group. When the company began producing its own cigarettes in the 1960s, its initial offering, Rembrandt, quickly became a popular option among South African smokers. Afterward, the Rupert family divided the company in two, founding Remgro Limited, which concentrated on mining, and Venfin Limited, which specialized in financial services. His father, Anton Rupert, is forever credited with starting with a 10 euro investment and growing it into a billion-dollar enterprise. Even after Anton's death, the family business has continued to expand, and it currently operates on 6 continents and in more than 30 countries. Following Anton's death, both companies under Johann Rupert's guidance have risen to become some of the most well-known firms in the whole globe. Johann Rupert's financial wealth, on the other hand, has never been stable. He was placed on Forbes' list of the world's wealthiest individuals in April 2019, with a net worth of $5.9 billion. Previously, he was claimed to have had a net worth of $7.3 billion, but that figure then decreased to $5.9 billion. However, by 2021, the savvy businessman had returned with a net worth of more than $7.1 billion, a significant increase from its previous level of $5.4 billion. And now, as of February 2022, he's valued at $8.8 billion. Johann's resurgence is solely the result of his extensive holdings spread over 6 continents. According to present estimates, Rupert may be on his way to being Africa's richest man. However, with such an impressive record of wealth comes a package of pleasure and luxury like never seen before, and Johann Rupert is no exemption. Individuals who are famous or affluent in society are well known for living extravagantly and luxuriously, and for lavishly spending significant sums of money on exotic automobiles. People like Johann Rupert, on the other hand, appear to have taken the purchasing of exotic vehicles to a whole new level of sophistication. His automobile collection is so vast and distinctive that he created the Franz Hoch Motor Museum. And because of the approximately 200 unique and precious automobiles on show at the Motor Museum, it's difficult to characterize it as anything other than a nirvana for automotive enthusiasts. The museum's spectacular collection of antique vehicles, motorcycles, and bicycles all in pristine condition will leave you speechless even if you aren't a fan of Top Gear. From a 1903 Ford Model A to a Rolls-Royce Phantom II to a 3-wheel Messerschmitt cabin scooter, each car has a fascinating story to tell about its past and present. At any given moment, around 80 breathtaking autos are on display in 4 temperature and humidity-controlled exhibition halls. The lighting and audio visuals are of the highest quality, and all of the autos are shown in chronological order in a spacious, uncrowded setting. Every one of the Dutch-style barn-like structures is dedicated to a different automotive manufacturer, and each of the structures is designed to exhibit 1 or 2 different models. The museum is home to the largest collection of vintage and antique autos in the country, which includes bicycles, pedal cars, antiques, race cars, and exotic motor vehicles, among other things. 20 vehicles from the collection, all in excellent condition, are on display in each hall and are driven on a regular basis to ensure they remain roadworthy and operational. He also owns a 63 Ferrari Lusso GT. He is the richest man in South Africa, and he lives in a mansion that would be appropriate for a king or queen. According to some estimates, his property in Cape Town is worth more than 200 million euros, but no one knows what's inside or what kind of amenities he has, because he lives a very secret life. As a multi-billionaire, he's rumored to invest in everything that strikes his attention. One example is when he paid 40 million rands for a bull in South Africa. Nonetheless, given that the interior of his dwelling remains a mystery, why don't we have a look at his estate, the Lomarins estate. It's a beautiful sight to behold. But still, we wouldn't expect anything less from the entrepreneur, who's the owner of the Swiss luxury goods company Richemont and the South African mining company Remgro. From the moment you set foot on the Lomarins estate, you can anticipate lavishness and superb taste, all blended with the winemaking spirit. Among his many accomplishments is the construction of the Terra del Capo vaults, which are the only ones of their kind on the whole continent. So it should come as no surprise that their wines have garnered several honors throughout the years. Even though it contains 9 vineyards, the wine profile isn't the only thing that'll take your breath away. What makes the estate unique is what is contained within it. There's also a sampling area at the property's entry, which offers a peaceful and exquisite introduction to the Terra del Capo line. A stunning view of the mountains can be enjoyed via clear glass walls, which also allows you to see what's going on down in the cellar. There's also an antipasto bar, where guests can get a quick bite to eat or experiment with different taste combinations. The Johann Rupert tasting room is housed in the renovated old mansion, which is located a little further down the road on the property. If the prior owner's name is anything to go by, you can expect to be met by Cape Dutch-style furnishings and historical art gracing the walls. Everything about it is spectacular, from the front veranda to the rear patio, which has views of the Franschhoek wine valley, to the Groot Drakenstein mountains, and everything in between. Well, what more could you want when you have a wine valley and world-class tasting rooms at your disposal? Horses, of course. On the estate is a stud farm, where horses are raised and trained. If this isn't the billionaire lifestyle, then what is? Well, and that's all for today's video, guys. What do you think about Johann Rupert? What about his vehicle collection? Comment below, let's engage. Also, please leave a like, subscribe, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell. Lastly, click on one of these videos on the screen to watch another amazing, luxurious video. Goodbye, see ya on the other side.